So I want to talk to you about your transition to a new identity. I mean, unless you're going to continue in your same profession until your very last breath, you're all going to go through this reinvention process. And most of you will do it unconsciously, but I recommend being very conscious about the transition process. And that means knowing how these transitions happen. Well, I happen to agree with the work of the late William Bridges, who developed the theories of transition. There are three phases to transition. The first one is the end. Yes, all transitions begin with an end. And I know that sounds counterintuitive, but it's true. If you think about graduating college, moving, losing a loved one, retiring, this is when we identify really what we're losing and how to manage those losses. We learn how to manage them. And also recognizing what is truly over and being left behind and what parts we can keep and incorporate into our new identity. In retirement terms, it's letting go. The next phase, the second phase, is the neutral zone. It's the in-between time when the old is gone, but the new isn't here yet. It's the time between our past identity and our new role in society. If it was a job we lost, well, this phase would be the job search. If it was a lost loved one, it includes the stages of grief and then the searching for, well, what am I going to do now? Now, this neutral phase can be short or long. And it's the time between an end and that new beginning, when a door is closed, but a window hasn't opened yet, but you know it's going to. You know, in retirement terms, it's the search for what you will retire to. It's waiting, it's hoping, exploring, trying new things, trying a variety of directions. It's important to note that it's easy to get stuck in this phase. In fact, too easy, really. I mean, when you're in this, shall we say, experimental phase, you're really bouncing around trying things out. You don't have to commit to any one direction yet. I mean, it might be a rough time for you, or you might be having fun with the variety. But the most you'll get is fun and pleasure in this phase. Your purpose and your fulfillment are yet to come. During this phase, you'll ask yourself these questions over and over again. What do I see myself doing? What do I want to do? And don't be surprised if day after day after day, you answer with, I don't know. I really don't know yet. It's okay. You keep trying. You keep exploring. It often requires the help of someone to pull you out of phase two and push you into phase three. Now, it's also worth noting that transitions are meant to be moved through. They are not a place to park and stay. Well, phase three of the transition process is your fresh start, your new beginning. This is when we're filled with excitement and passion, optimism. The birds are chirping. Julie Andrews comes running over the hillside singing, and there's music in the air. Everything is more colorful, more vibrant, right? Life is good. In retirement terms, it's a new beginning. It could be a new job, discovering your personal passion, joining the board of a nonprofit, getting into or out of a relationship, or could be even be leaving to go sail around the world. It could be maybe a new entrepreneur, maybe you're tutoring, you're volunteering, or you're raising money for Alex's lemonade stand like we did today. Hopefully, it's something that gives you purpose and fulfillment, and for some, the feeling that you're part of something larger than yourself. You'll have found new ways of being needed and involved, respected, valued. You'll feel like somebody again. You'll feel alive again. You have purpose. You have fulfillment. Heck, you feel like a VIP again. It's important to note that all of you who are listening to this, the educated, the active, the busy, with retirement savings, you are prone to be the least satisfied in retirement until you find your new beginning. So what's your encore? What's your encore?